Good morning. Welcome to the monastery. My name is Robert Stanford, and today is the Ascension of the Lord, Year C. We also welcome those who are watching from home on our streaming process there. Our celebrant is Father Dennis. Sorry about that. Please stand and join in singing our opening hymn. Welcome to everyone. You might have thought for a minute that Rob had a senior moment, but it was actually a pre-planned test to see if you knew me. Let's also make sure we at least know who's next to us. We might welcome each other to Mass today. We want to say a special welcome to those joining us online this morning and praying with us at home. Welcome to you also. Before we begin, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and the grace and peace and God of God our Father and the Lord Jesus be with you all. And today we are praying together on this feast of the Ascension of the Lord. And so in humility we call, Lord Jesus, you were lifted up to draw all people to yourself. Lord, have mercy. Lord, you shouldered the cross and you bore our suffering. Christ, have mercy. Lord, you opened for your people the way to salvation. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on you, forgive you your sins, and bring you to life everlasting. We pray. of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Mercy on us. You alone are the Holy One. You alone are omnipotent. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, glory of God the Let us pray. God our Father, make us joyful in the ascension of your Son, Jesus Christ, whom we follow. May we follow him into the new creation, for his ascension is our glory and hope. We pray through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In my earlier work, Theophilus, I dealt with everything Jesus had done and taught from the beginning until the day he gave his instructions to the apostles he had chosen through the Holy Spirit. And he was taken up to heaven. He had shown himself alive to them, his passion by many demonstrations. For 40 days he had continued to appear to them and tell them about the kingdom of God. When he had been at table with them, he had told them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for what the Father had promised. "It is," he said, "what you have heard me speak about. John baptized with water, but you, not many days from now, will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." Now, having met together, they asked him, "Lord, has the time come? Are you going to restore the kingdom to Israel?" He replied, "It is not for you to know times or dates that the Father has decided by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and then you will be my witnesses, not only in Jerusalem, but throughout Judea and Samaria, and indeed to the ends of the earth." As he said this, he was lifted up while they looked on, and a cloud took him from their sight. They were still staring into the sky when suddenly two men in white were standing near them, and they said, "Why are you men from Galilee standing here looking into the sky? Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, the same Jesus will come back in the same way as you have seen him go there." The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. All peoples, clap your hands, cry to God with shouts of joy. For the Lord, the Most High, we must fear, great King over all the earth. God goes up with shouts of joy. The Lord goes up with trumpet blast. Sing praise for God. Sing praise. Sing praise to our King. Sing praise. God is King of all the earth. Sing praise with all your skill. God is King over the nations. God reigns on his holy throne. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. May the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you spirit of wisdom and perception of what is revealed, to bring you to full knowledge of him. May he enlighten the eyes of your mind so that you can see what hope his call holds for you, what rich glories he has promised the saints will inherit, and how infinitely great is the power that he has exercised for us believers. This you can tell from the strength of his power at work in Christ, when he used it to raise him from the dead and to make him sit at the right hand in heaven, far above sovereignty, authority, power, or domination, or any other name that can be named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. He has put all things under his feet and made him as the ruler of everything, the head of the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills the whole creation. This is the word of the Lord. And teach all people my gospel. I am with you always until the end of the earth.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "You see how it is written that the Christ would suffer and on the third day rise from the dead, and that in his name repentance for the forgiveness of sin would be preached to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses to this. And now, I'm sending down to you what the Father has promised. Stay in the city then until you are clothed with the power from on high." Then he took them out as far as the outskirts of Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. Now as he blessed them, he withdrew from them and was carried up to heaven. They worshipped him and then went back to Jerusalem full of joy. And they were continually in the temple praising God. The Gospel of the Lord. And some years ago, two of our Passionist priests were preaching in a small country town in New South Wales. In the course of their week that they spent in the town, they met an older Indigenous Australian. His name was Cubby. He was a great personality and almost life of the town. It's a strange name, and he explained that when he was just a baby, of course, his family moved from place to place, taking furniture. And in fact, his crib or his bassinet was simply one of the drawers from a chest. He was just small enough to fit inside the draw, nice and warm and comfortable and cubby, and it became known as his little place, and the name stayed, and he held it for the rest of his life. What was important for them that they observed was that he was not simply just a kind person, but that he found God everywhere he went. He, of course, found God in nature and the environment and the land. But he found God in the people he was with, in the conversations he had, in the work he did for St. Vincent de Paul, for the less privileged. He found God in all sorts of ways. He lived and breathed Jesus. He was filled with the Spirit. And so it wasn't any surprise to them that one day when they asked him the question, "Cubby, what do you think Jesus would do if he came to our town today?" And without thinking, Cubby just said, "Well, I'd put on the kettle and make them a cup of tea and call them round. without realizing that he had stepped into the first person, and he was speaking as if he was Jesus looking after them. That was the depth of the Spirit's life in him. He breathed and lived the Spirit of Jesus. And that might be a really good example for us to listen to as we think about the Ascension, one of the mysteries of the resurrection and Christ's risen life with us now. Because it's tied in to all of the other mystery of Christ. The early Christians, they never separated one Sunday for the resurrection and one day for the Ascension and one day for Pentecost. They held them all together. It was just one great feast of Easter. It was all the same dynamic, if it had three movements, but the same dynamic. That Jesus rose, that he returned to the triune God, that he gave us his Spirit. All one moment. Today we're focusing on one aspect of that mystery. But it's important that we think of it and know it. It's not an abandonment. It's not as if the Lord has left this earth and that we are left standing, as the scripture said, staring into the sky. The reality is that this is part of a mystery by which we were endowed, gifted, with the same Spirit that moved and motivated Jesus. So we now possess the Holy Spirit, the Spirit that shifted and shaped and moved his life, inspired him. And what a wonderful act of trust on the part of God that is, that Jesus isn't physically present in this world in the way he was in Palestine 2,000 years back, but that God has trusted us, each one of us, and us as a community, with carrying on the work of Jesus and given us the same Spirit. Everything that moved Jesus moves us. The life of God that was in him, in the Spirit, is in us. So today, rather than thinking perhaps in vertical terms, let's think about this feast as the moment when we were commissioned to go out and continue the mission of Jesus in this world, to still be the physical manifestation of God's love in the world. For Jesus, that was obviously very important. The two principal commissions in this moment with the followers, with the disciples, was to firstly send them out to bring reconciliation, which might be a very important message in this week of national reconciliation, but reconciliation at every level, not simply a social reconciliation, but a moral one, interpersonal one, a spiritual one. We're to be witnesses to that power in this world. And the other great gift was joy. We're meant to be happy. We're meant to be joyful Christians. Our message is one of absolute goodness and good news. So we don't have to apologize for that. And it's a source of our own inner happiness. We don't have to be happy in a serious way. We simply have to be happy. That's the commission. So today, let's celebrate the reality of the mystery of Christ, and most certainly he reigns in heaven as part of the triune God. But we are also entrusted with his mission here on earth. And we have now to keep alive his good news so that people in every generation hear it again and again. The world is saved, but lots of people have not yet heard that message of good news. Perhaps then today we might learn from people like Cubby. Let's live our lives as ambassadors for Jesus. Let's witness to him in all we do, Let's love other people as he did, and let's speak as if he were the one giving us the words. And let's stand and profess our faith in the same Lord. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. On the third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. My sisters, my brothers, in today's reading from Acts, we heard the disciples were looking at the sky, not understanding where Jesus was going. Knowing that our relationship with Christ transcends time and space, let us lift up our prayers today, confident that we will be heard.
That our church may grow in intimacy with God through witnessing Jesus' life and sharing the joy of relationship. Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
That all who work for peace may find support and nourishment for their work, sustained always by the Holy Spirit. Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
That all who are at places of transition in their lives may look forward with courage to the future, relying on the strength of their relationship with others in Jesus Christ. Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
That all who feel abandoned, especially children who are orphans or separated from their families, may they know the warmth of love in relationship and community. Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
We pray for those who are sick and for those who have asked for our prayers. We pray for those whom God has called from this life, and for those whose anniversaries occur at this time. Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us. Loving God, our prayers are not secret to you. We raise them today to grow in intimacy with you, trusting that you are always with us, no matter the circumstance. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In all that we do. the Father, may we live always in witness to you.
So my sisters and brothers, let us pray that our sacrifice might be acceptable to God the Most High. Grant, Almighty God, that we who believe that your only begotten Son, our Redeemer, ascended this day to the heavens, may in spirit dwell already in heavenly realms. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, always, everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, most holy, almighty and eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and us, judge of the world, Lord of hosts, he ascended, not to distance himself from us, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people proclaims your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In the same way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered together into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Patrick our Bishop, the clergy, and all who lead us and guide us in the way of faith. Remember our sisters and brothers who've gone to their rest in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her beloved spouse, with the apostles and saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we too may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him, with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. Let's pray as Jesus taught the disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord, deliver us, we pray, from every evil. Grant us peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, keep us always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but look on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always." To those near us, let's offer a sign of that peace. This is the body and blood of Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are we who share his life at this, the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am worthy to change you in my room. Only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep us all safe for everlasting life.
We will see you when you call.
Father, in this Eucharist we touch the divine life you give to the world. Help us to follow Christ with love to eternal life, where he is Lord forever and ever.
There's a handful of messages, announcements this week. This is the final week you can provide your thoughts on the draft version of the parish vision statement. The link is in the bulletin. The Passionate Companions are meeting in the Dollard Room next Friday evening at 7 p.m. Mass in honour of the Immaculate Heart of Mary will be held next Saturday, the 4th of June, at 12 p.m. at St. Raphael's Church. And the next high tea at the monastery will be held on Sunday, the 5th of June 2022. Please contact the office to make a booking. And Father Dennis, I thank you for Mass.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. No. That was all worked out. It was all worked out. Well, let's take that joy with us into this week. The Lord be with you. To those at home, to those here, let us ask God's blessing upon us. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain always with you. And let us go in the peace of Christ. Enjoy the day.
So.